The U.S. Environmental Protection Agency has issued new guidance on PFAS chemicals in drinking water, lowering its lifetime health advisory significantly from levels announced in 2016.
Now, these chemicals have been made by companies like 3M in Decatur for decades, and the chemicals don't easily break down. They are used in a wide array of consumer products, from Teflon to water-repellent clothing. The EPA says the chemicals have been linked to immune system development and heart problems and some cancers.
And PFAS chemical contamination of the Tennessee River has been the subject of long-running litigation in North Alabama. News 19 Chief Investigative Reporter Brian Lawson joins us in the studio with more. So, Brian, this is a major announcement by the EPA.
It really is. The key thing to know first is that these are recommendations, not regulations, so not enforceable by law. What EPA is saying is that continued health studies suggest its prior guidance of 70 parts per trillion for PFAS chemicals in drinking water is too high for a lifetime exposure. They've lowered it to 0.02 parts per trillion, and for PFOA chemicals, 0.004 parts per trillion. Now, the EPA has said it expects to propose formal drinking water regulations later this year, with the new rules in place by 2023. David Whiteside, founder of Tennessee Riverkeeper, a group that sued 3M over PFAS contamination, said the new guidelines will affect cleanup efforts.
These recommendations are more strict than the experts thought were going to be released, and it certainly is going to force cities and 3M and the other polluters and groups like Riverkeeper to look more closely, and for 3M to have to clean up their mess more thoroughly to meet these standards.
Now, the EPA is making $1 billion in grants available to utilities to help them address PFAS levels. The Alabama Department of Environmental Management is also involved, saying in part, quote, "ADEM, along with the Alabama Department of Public Health, has been coordinating with water systems in Alabama that had measurable levels of PFAS to provide any assistance they may need. While the advisories are for a lifetime of exposure, ADEM is working with the drinking water systems to resolve the PFAS issues in the near-term future. EPA's lifetime health advisories identify levels to protect all people, including sensitive populations and life stages, from adverse health effects resulting from exposure throughout their lives, these PFAS in drinking water. The health advisory levels were calculated to offer a margin of protection against adverse health effects." That was from the EPA. As we've said, the new recommendations are well below the prior EPA levels. That means a number of water systems in North Alabama who are below the prior limit are now above it. We reached out to Decatur Utilities. The utility says they will be evaluating the new advisory levels and will make changes as needed. You can read that full statement on our website, whnt.com.